We're on the cusp of something extremely exciting making its way into WordPress core, and that is the idea of pattern overrides. Before we discuss that, we need to take a look at how patterns in WordPress function and operate right now, and if this feature that I'm going to show you here in just a little bit does make its way into WordPress core, it's going to really revolutionize your workflow. So let's go ahead and get started. First of all, I want to show you some example patterns, and these are things that I really do on, you know, some of my client websites and even my own projects, and that is set up some basic patterns for things like containers and content wrappers, and then for other things like buttons and common use cases like that. So now in WordPress 6.5 and later, when you go to appearance and patterns, you can see anything that you've created right in here natively. So you can see that I have a main container pattern, and all this is just a generate blocks container. And then in the inside, it's just got some default padding, you know, for rim, top and bottom. Now, this isn't exactly how I set it up, because with generate blocks, we have the ability to add global styles, which are just like CSS classes. But the idea is that I have these patterns for common layouts that I would create. Again, I also have my button here. It's just pre-styled. So then no matter where I am, like if I'm on my About Us page and I want to start to add some content, instead of building those components manually, I can just type in the name of that pattern, main container. And then if I wanted to stick my button in here, I could just type in, you know, main button, and those are popped in for us automatically, which is great. Now, the downside of these patterns is they are not synced in terms of their styling. So if I were to, you know, for whatever reason, change the background color of this button to, I don't know, something like this beautiful purple color, I can update this. And then, you know, if I view my homepage where we first saw it, that button is still blue. And of course, as you can guess, if I went to the patterns area, the button inside the pattern is still going to be blue. The exception to this is if you create what's known as a synced pattern. So on our homepage, I could go to hero content and I could turn this into a pattern. I'll just give this name hero content to the pattern, and then I can choose synced. So if I create that, then what happens is this pattern is synced in a way where I can attach it to as many pages as I want. If I change the content or the styling on one instance of that, then it reflects to all the other instances. However, there's even still a catch with that. So what this means is that I can't have unique content per instance of this pattern. So for instance, I called this hero content. Let's go back to our About Us page. We're going to just simply delete this, and we can type in the name of that pattern, which was hero content. So now it's going to have the exact same content. So let me just update this. Now, of course, we have our hero pattern on both our homepage and our About Us page. So if we go back to appearance and patterns, go to hero content, and let's just say, you know, the best travel guides, we'll add that. We can update this. So we've got that, and let's say, you know, we want to add that to our homepage, hero content. You can see it's updated the best travel guides here. Of course, this doesn't really make sense if I then wanted to add it to my About Us page. I'm going to want like a unique headline, a unique button, a unique image, but I don't want to change any of the other facets of this section here. I want to be able to edit the headline, the paragraph text, the image, the button, that kind of thing. But otherwise, I want to leave it alone. The spacing and the alignment and all of the styling properties, I want to remain the same. Not only that, but if I want to rearrange this, I want that to be reflected to all instances of my pattern. And if I add or remove an element from them, I also want that to be reflected. I've gone ahead and updated my homepage with this pattern to demonstrate this more effectively. So let's go to our About Us page, and we have the pattern there as well. So to demonstrate the really cool part of this, which is the pattern's override, what we have to do, because that's not currently in WordPress core, is we need to go add the Gutenberg plugin, which is like the way that you can test beta and alpha features that might make their way into core. We just simply activate this, and we got to do the stupid refresh thing, which is a consequence of the latest WordPress plugin update. I don't understand that. It's a conversation for a different time. Now that we have that activated, what we can do is we can go to our appearance and patterns. We can go, now this has changed too, and we can go to our hero content. And then if we click on this headline, we'll be able to set this as a pattern override. Please, 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 please let this work on other blocks that are non-core native blocks. Please, please. But to demonstrate how badass this is, what I'm going to do is go to advanced, then scroll down over here on the right hand side, and we see this button that says overrides, enable override. And down here is pretty much the best explanation of this. It says allow changes to this block throughout instances of this pattern, which is awesome. So we can go to enable overrides. And in this case, we are just going to call this CTA headline. We need to give this override a name. Then we need to repeat the exact same steps here. So we're going to go to enable overrides and we'll just call this CTA content enable. Okay. Same thing is true here with our button. Because this is a core button, we can go to the advanced tab, override, and you know, we can say, it filled in primary button there because it's a pattern, which is cool. And I've quickly gone ahead and swapped out the generate blocks image container that I was using in favor of this just core image block, because we can also swap out the image in this override as well. So if we go just call this, you know, CTA image enable, we can save this. Now what I'm going to do is go back to my pages. We're going to go to home. And of course, we already have this hero content section added to our page. So what we can do is we can just start typing something here. So welcome to our website. I'm just going to type something lame. And then we'll leave that text alone. Learn more, let's say, is something like register. We'll swap that here. Save this. Then let's go back to about us. In this case, you can say, you know, about Swiss adventures. Learn more, we can just swap to something like buy now, or maybe like reserve your spot. Then the image we can swap out as well. So I've swapped out that image here for a different one. So we can save this. And now when we go to our homepage and our about us, we can see that they have unique content in both of those locations. So that's pretty cool, but that's not the full story here. So let me show you one more thing, which is so cool and why this pattern override system is so awesome. So when I go back to my patterns again, I got to click through these couple of screens here. So go to hero content. And then let's say for whatever reason, you want to rearrange these or change their appearance or something like that. These are H2s, for instance. Let's say we want them to be an H1. Maybe we want this to be bolded. And then maybe, for instance, we want these containers to be swapped. And maybe we want a little bit of a gap between them now. So we'll just set, you know, 40 pixels of gap on both sides. We'll save this. Then now what we can do is go back to our homepage and refresh. And you can see that we've inherited the styling changes there. And on the About Us page, once again, you can see that we've got the, you know, swapped layout and we have the bold font. And everything else about this is still the same. We have the unique text in all the other spots. And that's what makes this so cool. Pattern overrides are freaking sick. You can see there's a lot of steps we have to go through here to really understand why pattern overrides is so awesome and why this is such a technically complex thing to solve. So with this system here, we now have one single pane of glass, one source of truth to modify any common sections like this. So imagine you had, you know, a four feature card that you used all over your website. Even if you attach global styles or classes all over to them, it still doesn't actually affect the raw HTML. So yeah, you could change things like the heading, you know, font weight or whatever, but what's so cool about it is it affects the HTML just as you saw, which is how I was able to change the order of that grid, make the image come first and the text come second. It's also worth pointing out that we can add new components inside of this as well. So if I wanted to add, you know, another text block inside of this, I can certainly do that. I can add and remove components. Of course, they'll need their own overrides as well. But for the sake of example, let's get rid of this paragraph and let's delete this button. Let's delete the button properly like that. Then we can save, go back to About Us and our homepage. And you can see in both cases, the button is now gone. Just one more time to reiterate. Let's just pop in a button. We'll just type in learn more. This one's not going to be overridden because we haven't applied that, but it's going to bring the button back for us. How insanely sick is that? Pattern overrides are really, really cool. As you now know, currently it's not available in WordPress core. I think it's planned for 6.6, so hopefully that comes in the next few months. And hopefully this ability extends out to other third-party blocks. So that's why I titled this video in such a way to tell you how awesome this feature is, but how there's just a little bit more to go. I hope this feature is as exciting to you as it is to me. If you're not subscribed here, please consider doing so. My name is Jonathan Jernigan, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.